Story is only 6 weeks old, but she already has one to tell.
Yeah, she definitely went through withdrawals. They were pretty severe for her.
A lot of kids.
Fussiness, upper respiratory problems, trouble gaining weight were just some of them. Story was born with NAS, neonatal abstinence syndrome. In 2016, 8% of all babies in Maine are born withdrawing from drugs.
So you're a pregnant mom and you're supposed to sacrifice anything for your baby. In a perfect world you would.
Sarah takes Subutex. It helps keep her sober, and she has been for 2 years. But like so many moms and pregnant women, opioid addiction had a tight grip on her.
So I will tell you that in that first week, if I had been able to get my hands on something, I probably would have used. It was really, really stressful.
But she in part credits a program at St. Mary's in Lewiston with keeping her on the right track. We profiled the program last year and now find it's doubled in that time.
We've actually had to grow to two groups now instead of just one, because we were overfilling our room capacity, which is good news, because patients were starting to come and really acknowledge that there's a problem and come seek help and doing a lot of that education.
The group includes about 10 pregnant women and moms who have recently delivered, who discuss everything from pregnancy to parenting, addiction to recovery.
And it's really grown into more than just that group time. These patients are also connecting in the outside world and working together to better their lives and kind of set things back up again.
This program at St. Mary's is a current model for treatment here in the state.
This is just continuing to go up.
Dr. Gregory Hardy is the chief medical officer at Stevens Memorial Hospital in Norway. In Oxford County, for example, the number of babies born with neonatal abstinence syndrome, or drug affected, each year has tripled since 2009.
It happens not infrequently over the years. You'll deliver the baby, you'll know the mom very well, you'll know the social situation, not ideal, and you see them walking out the door, and you just worry.
Dr. Hardy took part in a conference this summer to figure out what's needed to treat this problem. Much of it comes down to a lack of resources in rural communities.
Because we're not set up with the resources to deal with the neonatal abstinence syndrome here, at about 36 weeks of pregnancy, they actually transfer down to Maine Medical Center for their deliveries. Something we're working on changing depending upon how we can develop the resources.
While the work at area healthcare providers continues, so does the work for the women where pregnancy, creating life, can mean a new one of their own.
It's such a hard thing to do.
Sarah LaPierre says she's an example of someone whose life outside the program doors may have been saved by the doors that have opened because of it.
Yeah, it definitely became a source of support for me to be able to make those difficult decisions like, you know, I've got, you know, stuff is going to change.
And Sarah says by telling her story, she hopes to reduce the stigma and bring this problem out of the shadows, showing pregnant women that there is help out there. And speaking of the topic of help, Dr. Hardy says that as they begin to develop those treatment best practices that we're talking about, that behavioral component is just as important as medical treatment.